Hello there, good morning. You're watching Proactive London, and joining us today we have Bradley Duke from ETC Group. Bradley, how are you? Happy New Year.
Happy New Year to you.
You've got off to a great start because today you've had your listing on six Swiss exchanges. Talk us through it and the currencies that are involved as well, if you would, Bradley.
Sure. So, as you know, we had initially listed on XETRA, on Deutsche Börse's XETRA board. That was in June 2020. And now we're listing BTCE, which is the our Bitcoin ETP, on six Swiss exchange today. And today, what's different about this listing is that, well, firstly, it's on a different exchange, and we'll get exposure to different investors, local investors and asset managers. But also the listing is in US dollar, in GBP and pounds sterling, and also in Swiss francs as well, CHF. So that, you know, that's important to a lot of investors because they don't want to add, you know, additional costs to their investment by having to do the FX piece as well. So, you know, if they typically are investing in Swiss francs, then, you know, this is useful for them to be able to get exposure to price movements in Bitcoin through BTCE and CHF.
Brilliant. And in terms of sort of the inflows that you've seen and the attention that you've garnered, so you've gone from some $75 million before Christmas, now you're seeing sort of $500 million, yeah. Right? Just explain this, because it does seem like mind-boggling numbers.
Right. Well, so this is a combination of two things. The one is the price of Bitcoin itself, which, as you know, on Friday it went over $40,000, which is even saying that out loud is quite you know, it's remarkable. You know, where it was trading when we listed, it was trading at around $9,000-$10,000in June last year. So that's, you know, that's a, you know, fourfold increase, which is remarkable in and of itself. But also what we're seeing is we are seeing the investment community, in particular institutional asset managers, now wanting to get exposure to Bitcoin. This is part what's behind the driving of the price, but also we're seeing, you know, a greater number of units of BTCE being created and sold to fulfill demand for products like ours. Behind this demand, and why the institutional asset manager wants to now get involved in an asset class like cryptocurrency, it's a lot to do with COVID. It's got a lot to do with the fact that there's governments around the world are you know, using money supply to fund these stimulus packages, which are sorely needed by local economies to help jumpstart them, or to, you know, to keep to try avert a real you know, sort of human catastrophe in terms of the damage that's being done by the coronavirus. But at the same time, you know, investors understand that increasing money supply to fund this kind of stimulus package has a devaluing effect on the currency and can actually lead to inflation. So increasingly investors are seeing Bitcoin and products like BTCE as a hedge to inflation.
While we're talking about Bitcoin though, we must address the fact that this week in particular has been incredibly tumultuous, hasn't it? I mean, you mentioned the fourfold, but we've also seen a bit of a comeback as well, maybe largely because of what the FCA said as well. They issued a bit of a warning, really, didn't they?
Yeah, it was an interesting one. We saw the FCA some weeks ago banning investment access products like ours for the retail investor. Not this. This doesn't account to the professional or the institutional investor. And this is only UK only. So other countries in Europe weren't affected by their decision. Mm-hmm. And this product again is listed in Germany, and it has a retail and a professional eligible prospectus. But what they did do from the 6th of January in the UK retail investor was forced to actually, if they wanted to get exposure to Bitcoin, to actually go to, you know, often unregulated exchanges and actually have to manage the storage of the Bitcoin themselves, which, you know, products like ours were solving that problem. You know, it's traded on a regulated, BTC is traded on a regulated exchange, which has got a lot of built-in market abuse features. And also, you know, we handle the storage of the underlying or the Bitcoin that's backing the product. You know, the product is 100% backed by physical Bitcoin, and is fungible as well with the underlying Bitcoin. So now for the retail investor, those options are no longer there, and they're really left to fend for themselves. And then the FCA went a little bit further than that when the price of Bitcoin started to rise by saying, you know, that the price of Bitcoin could fall to zero. And, you know, there was quite a fair amount of scaremongering that was going on. And, you know, I mean, it's important to note that this is the case with, you know, most investment products that you invest in. If you're investing in, like, say, a company like Enron, which is, you know, it can collapse and go to zero. This is understood by the investor, and this is part of the risk-adjusted view that the investor takes when they're looking at, you know, sizing out the investor for themselves. But it was interesting that they on the one hand were taking away the ability for the retail investor to invest securely, and on the other hand were warning people about the risks associated with investing in cryptocurrencies in general.
There's really never a dull moment when it comes to cryptocurrencies, and it's a fascinating story to watch. And just maybe, you know, you mentioned June there, phenomenal 6 months or so that you've had. In conclusion, I guess I've got to ask you, what's going to happen for the next 6 months?
Okay, so we've, you know, it has been an amazing a few weeks now, really since the new year has been remarkable. We've seen trading days in BTCE of over $125 million, you know, which is remarkable. We've hit a lot of records with that. You know, we first broke 100 million and then 125 million trading volume in one day. And I think on that day, there was over 3.4 million units of BTCE that changed hands, which in and of itself is remarkable. And it really plays well into the liquidity story that we've always been trying to build, you know, for the institutional investor to make sure that our product is very liquid. And also very, with trades at very tight spreads. But in terms of ETC Group, and we have new products coming out. Besides this listing today, we've got new products that we'll be announcing very, very soon. We're just waiting for the final approvals, and you know, hopefully, you'll have me back on the show to discuss those products when they're available. But that's coming really soon. And then we've got some other interesting products, novel products that we'll be hopefully be able to announce very soon as well.
Brilliant. Sounds like we'll be having you back very soon indeed. That's Bradley Duke there from ETC Group discussing your collaboration with Hanetf. Thank you.
Thank you very much.